Hi, I am Dr. Selvaraj, your surgical educator from Malaysia. Welcome back to my series of surgical teaching video casts. These are meant mainly for undergraduate medical students doing the surgical clerkship rotation. I promise you will become competent in clinical problem solving and surgical decision making if you are going to watch these videos over and over again. Today in this episode, I am going to discuss one more image based question in vascular surgery. This is image number 2. Our patient is a 47 year old man, a known case of hypertension, diabetic mellitus, tobacco abuse and coronary artery disease, presents to the emergency room with a 3-week history of spontaneous ulceration of the left great toe and increasing rest pain in the left foot. Vital signs are normal. On examination, there is dry gangrene at the base of left great toe with mild surrounding cellulitis. The patient has dry and hairless skin of the bilateral lower extremities. Bilateral femoral and popliteal pulses are palpable. Pedal pulses are absent to palpation, but there is an audible Doppler signal at the left dorsal ispidus. There is no sensory or motor loss. So this is the clinical presentation, and these are the 5 pictures and these are the 4 questions. So question number 1, what is your diagnosis based on this clinical presentation and why you are saying so? Question number 2, what you are seeing in figure 1 and figure 2? This is figure 1 and this is figure 2. Question number 3, what investigation is done in figure 3 and the findings in that investigation? This is the figure number 3. Question number 4, what are the surgical interventions done in figure 4 and figure 5? This is figure 4 and this is figure 5. So now I am requesting my viewers to pause the video and try to answer all these 4 questions. So after answering, you can verify your answer with the correct answers, which I am going to discuss in the subsequent slides. So question number 1, what is your diagnosis and why you are saying so? The correct answer is, the diagnosis is chronic lower limb ischemia, left side, probably because of atherosclerosis above the knee level. Because he is a known case of diabetic, hypertension, coronary artery disease, and he is also a smoker. All these things are risk factors to develop limb ischemia. Patient also experienced rest pain in left foot and he is holding his left foot with both of his hands. You can see it here. He is holding his left foot, which is bandaged probably because of the gangrene, and he is holding it and his face probably is weeping or he is in agony. This you can see. And if you carefully watch, there is dry gangrene present over the base of the left greater toe and there is dry hairless skin present in the left lower limb. See, there are no hairs here. And you are seeing at the base of the great toe, on the left foot, you are seeing a gangrene. Already there is gangrene there. This is dry gangrene. And pedal pulses are absent in the left side as well as on the right side also, they said it's absent. With these findings, with these clinical findings, probably our patient is a case of chronic lower limb ischemia in rest pain stage, and that is one of the critical limb ischemia. Rest pain and then the ulceration and frank gangrene everything comes under critical limb ischemia, whereas the intermittent claudication stage is lifestyle limiting ischemia. Here it is critical limb ischemia. Unless you are going to intervene surgically, okay, your patient is going to lose the limb. That's why it's called critical limb ischemia. Question number two, what you are seeing in figure 1 and in figure 2? This is figure 1, figure 2. So the correct answer is, in figure 1, patient is holding his left foot with both of his hands because of excruciating pain, that is the rest pain. This is because of the cry of the dying nerves. The nerves, supplying nerves, because of lack of blood supply, they are going to die. And that is why these patients are having this severe pain. In intermittent claudication pain, patient experience pain one level below the level of obstruction anywhere in the lower limb. It can happen anywhere. The pain can occur in intermittent claudication. Patient can perceive the pain in the thigh, in the calf region, or even in the foot. But whereas in rest pain, the patient will perceive the pain only in the foot. This is the difference. In figure 2, here, there is dry gangrene at base of the left great toe. This is a case of critical limb ischemia, rest pain stage. Question number 3, what investigation is done in figure 3 and what are the findings? This is figure 3. The correct answer is, the investigation shown in figure 3 is DSA or digital subtraction angiogram. The bone and the soft tissue shadows have been subtracted from the original angiogram for better clarity. Otherwise, no, the bone also will be white in color, that will be superimposed over this arterial shadow, and that is why we are subtracting both the bone shadow as well as the soft shadow for clarity, good clarity. This should be done only if you are planning surgery. If it is in intermittent claudication stage, you need not do DSA. Only if you are planning surgery in case of critical limb ischemia, namely it could be a gangrene, it could be an ulcer, or it could be a just a color change. In all these things, you must do a DSA, because this is a roadmap to surgery. By doing this, you can precisely locate the exact site and the length of the obstruction. Where is the obstruction and how long is the obstruction? Both you can precisely locate by doing this DSA. And that is why if you are planning surgery, then only you have to do this DSA test. The three criteria you have to look in the DSA for successful surgical intervention are, number one, there should be good proximal run-in of the dye. Here you are seeing, this is the proximal run-in. The dye is running in the proximal vessel, and that is a good run-in. And there should be adequate collateral vessels. See, you are seeing lot of collateral vessels here. Adequate collateral vessels also should be visible. And the most important thing, you should also see a very good distal runoff of the dye. Because of these collaterals, all these dye will go into the distal vessel, which is not blocked. And you have to see a very good distal runoff of this dye also. Then only, if you do a bypass surgery, that will be a successful one. If you are not getting a very good distal runoff, you are not seeing this distal vessel, then you cannot do a bypass surgery. Question number 4, what are the surgical interventions done in figure 4 and in figure 5? This is figure 4, this is figure 5. The correct answer is, the figure 4 shows the localized block in superficial femoral artery, which is less than 2 cm. You can see here, this is a DSA, this is showing a block or stenosis of the superficial femoral artery here. And you are seeing an adequate proximal run-in, adequate good distal runoff, and lot of collaterals you are seeing. So since it is a localized block, PTLA or percutaneous transluminal angioplasty was done in this patient. And in the next picture, here in this picture, you can see there is no narrowing of the vessel. This narrowing is disappeared after PTLA. Okay, and all collaterals also disappeared. All these collateral vessels also disappeared because of after doing this PTLA procedure or percutaneous transluminal angioplasty. In figure 5 here, it shows the bypass surgery if the block is more than 4 centimeters. Very lengthy block means you have to do, you should not do the PTLA. Now you have to do a bypass surgery. In the first picture here, these two pictures, you are seeing aortoiliac block for which aorto bifemoral bypass was done. This is aortoiliac by aorto, both the iliacs are blocked. So this is what is called Leric syndrome or saddle thrombus. The patient will go for sterility or impotence. Yeah, that is the Leric syndrome. So here you have to do what is called aorto bifemoral bypass. This is what you have to do. In the second picture, you are seeing superficial femoral block here. Superficial femoral artery is blocked, but it is lengthy, more than 4 cm, for which femoropopliteal bypass was done. Femoral to popliteal. Femoropopliteal bypass was done. For above knee bypass surgeries, you can use both saphenous vein and biological synthetic grafts like PTFE, polytetrafluoroethylene, and Dacron you can use. For below knee bypass, you should use only saphenous vein and not the synthetic material because these veins are very small. If you are going to use these synthetic materials, that will get blocked. So you have to use only saphenous vein. While using the saphenous vein, you have to reverse, either you have to reverse the vein or you have to destroy the walls inside. Then only you can use it for the bypass surgery, the great saphenous vein. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you think that these videos are very useful, kindly subscribe to this channel and share these videos in your social media. Kindly click the bell button also to get notified regarding my latest upload. Thank you once again for watching this video. Let us meet in yet another episode. Until then, bye-bye.